Number 10 denied it was the source that led to 15 Conservative Remainers being named and shamed yesterday for plotting to join Labour rebels and vote against setting Britain's Brexit date into UK law. But if the story was an attempt to dissuade rebels from voting against the Prime Minister's plan to quit the EU at 11 p.m. on March 29, 2019, it appears to have had the opposite effect. The number of Conservative MPs preparing to defy the government is believed to have risen beyond 20, according to The Times, with their own designated WhatsApp group to organize a plan of attack. Gideonis O'Brien is among the growing number of Tory rebels who could derail Theresa May's Brexit plan. So far, the government has successfully negotiated 2 days of line-by-line scrutiny to see its European withdrawal bill passed unamended. But after the ill-fated snap election saw Theresa May's majority wiped out, it would now only take 18 rebels to defeat the government on any aspect of the legislation. Yesterday, Anna Sobry, a prominent Remain supporter, struck a defiant tone as she described her inclusion on the front page of The Telegraph under the Brexit Mutineers headline as a badge of honor in the House of Commons. She revealed her office had reported about half a dozen threatening tweets to the police as a result, which she said was a blatant piece of bullying that goes to the very heart of democracy. Another unarmed rebel Tory told The Times they suspected Number 10 itself had leaked the names of the 15 rebels, claims a Whitehall source denied. Many, if not all, of the mutineers, such as Ms. Sobry and former Chancellor Ken Clark, are well known for their anti-Brexit stance, but the latest comments give an indication of the toxic atmosphere sweeping through the Tories and Labour as parties are split over Brexit. Yesterday at Prime Minister's Questions, Mrs. May said she was listening to MPs as the line-by-line scrutiny of the EU withdrawal bill progresses. Ken Clark is another Tory rebel who featured on the controversial front page. She said there is of course a lively debate going on in this place. That is right and proper, and that is important. We are listening carefully to those who wish to improve the bill. I hope we can all come together to deliver on the decision that the country took that we should leave the European Union. The in-party fighting over Brexit is not contained to just the Conservatives. Labour MP Frank Field was also heckled by his own party members yesterday when he told them they needed educating over Brexit. He claimed the majority of Labour voters across the UK had voted to leave the EU, and that most MPs were GOIG against their constituents' wishes by trying to frustrate Brexit legislation.